Nimbus tested positive for FIV and negative for FELV on his combo test yesterday. So what does that mean? Well, the good thing is that FELV is the scary one. So that's the one that he was negative for. They're very commonly confused with each other because they get tested for both of them at the same time. And they have really similar names. So people confuse them very often. But they're very different viruses, extremely different viruses. So the one that we really don't want them to test positive for is FELV, and that's the one he's negative for. The one that he tested positive for is FIV. So what does this mean? Well, the first thing is that he tested positive, but in kittens, almost all kittens who test positive before they're 6 months, they actually don't have the virus. And we will retest him, or his adopters will retest him when he's 6 months old. And in all likelihood, when he's retested, he will test negative. That's just the way that it is. Why is that? So when we do the test, Taji, oh my goodness, I think I have to put him outside. He's being distracted. You can play in the hallway, but you're kind of, yeah, you're being stressful. Trying to have a conversation. So why would he test positive now and negative later? Because the test that is done is called a SNAP test, and it tests for antibodies. And in a kitten his age, if his mom was FIV positive, which is most likely the case, he ingested the FIV antibodies when he was nursing. And so he still has them inside him. So that would make the test positive. The antibodies eventually go away, but it doesn't mean that he actually has the virus. So that's the first thing, is that in all likelihood, even though he tested positive this time around, he probably doesn't have FIV, and he'll be retested when he's 6 months old, and he probably will come up negative then. That's the case with most kittens. So what if that's not the case? What if he is retested and he still tests positive? So let's say that he really does have FIV. What does that mean? FIV is not scary. FIV is not fatal. It's not a death sentence. Cats that have the virus live long and healthy lives. There's nothing wrong with them. They can live with any other cats. They can live with cats that are not infected with FIV. It's not transmitted through saliva or by sharing a litter box or anything like that. It is transmitted by doing the hanky-panky, which we know that our neutered Nimbus will not be doing. And it can be transmitted by a very deep bite, like into a vein, which happens with feral cats generally. So cats that are outdoors and they fight over territory, and they cause like serious wounds with each other. That's just not the case with domesticated cats. They just don't bite like that. So if you're familiar with Cole and Marmalade, the two really famous cats, Cole does not have FIV, and Marmalade does have FIV. They live together just perfectly fine. This is all, just saying that if the case was that, if it did come out that he did turn out in 6 months to have FIV, he does not have to be a single cat. He can be in other cat households. And it's totally safe. He doesn't need any kind of extra medical care. He'll get all his regular vaccines on schedule. He'll be neutered on schedule. So what's the difference? So FIV stands for feline immunodeficiency virus, which means that their immune system is a little weaker than other cats. So as long as a cat with FIV stays indoors, which is what we require, they are not exposed to the sicknesses and viruses and things outdoors that would make them sick. They stay healthy when they're indoors. They're not exposed to things. It's true, Marm is a cancer survivor too. He's like a rock star. Nimbus has, I don't know, the HR director just wanted to hire him. They were filling out paperwork for him as a permanent employee, and I don't even know what his job is. They said that they just wanted him to greet people at the door. It seems like a pretty easy job. So he can be around my cats, he can be around Taj. We still have to wait for Flapjack's results, his combo test, to see if he can be around Flapjack. So of course, for Flapjack, we just want to make sure that Flapjack is negative for FELV. That's the one that is very contagious. And shortens a cat's lifespan. So that's the one we don't want to see. But FIV is not scary. So if anything, the lesson for today is to remember the difference between FIV and FELV. FIV is okay. FELV is a sad face. And we'll see. Like I said, he'll probably be okay. Likelihood is he doesn't have it. He's really healthy. Doesn't necessarily mean anything, but he is really healthy. He had a great checkup other than that. Great vet visit. His age was spot on, so we're looking at the vet confirmed that his approximate birth date was around September 21st, so that's what we're going with. Not really, Michelle. There's no feline AIDS. I don't like using that term at all because there really is no such thing. Yeah, FELV is feline leukemia. So bouncy. He's so bouncy. This is how I got that Jazz Hands photo of him. He was just bouncing around in a chair. Bouncy, 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 bouncy. Don't even know. Oh, goodness. Poor Flapjack. Just feel like he's gonna topple. Yes, and please, please, please do not ever call FIV feline AIDS. It's a pet peeve of mine. There's no such thing as feline AIDS. Yeah. Runs like a hamster. He kind of bounces when he runs now, so I guess we'll see in this room. He's been in a smaller pen next door. This room is twice the size of the room next door, so he has a lot more space in here. He really loves to run though. However, odd way that he runs. It's okay, Michelle. It's just a thing, and this is a total education video, and it's my own thing. So, as much as I can talk about FIV here, just to be educational. And we happened to be able to use NIMBY as an opportunity. I hear Taji out there. Yeah, he's trying to break in. It's like having Tots again, trying to break in. FIV is not contagious to other cats in the typical way. So it's not contagious by sharing food bowls. It's not contagious by sharing litter boxes. It's shared by doing the hanky-panky, which would not happen because Nimbus will be fixed. And but that's how it spread outdoors in stray and feral populations, because of course they're mating outside. And it's shared by really deep bite wounds, which again doesn't happen with domestic cats because they're not vicious. That again happens out in like feral populations where they're fighting and over territory and mates and things like that. So within a household, we don't consider FIV contagious from one cat to another. It's not contagious to people or to dogs at all. We do have a potential foster for Lindsay, but I don't yet have an update as far as what's going on there yet. This was a very busy weekend, and I had a lot to get through before we can move on with that. So hopefully this coming week we'll have some more news about that. I know, that was MTV Mommy came up with Fluffy Pancakes, and I loved it. We got Cloud, NIMBY, and Flapjack, and together they make Fluffy Pancakes. So excited, but yeah, this biting has got to stop. You gotta start biting on toys. Gotta learn to bite on toys. What color are your toe beans? Yay, there she is. Thank you, KTV, for the idea. I love it. Pink toe beans. Any other questions about anything? Taj has a question. Oh, no way! I didn't see that on the gala. I watched a little bit of it, but I missed that part. Are you gonna play tic-tac-toe with me? He usually really likes this thing. This is a supervised toy though, because of these hazards, but he really likes it. So Leanne sent a very generous Amazon gift card and basically said, have at it and buy stuff for Nimby and Flapjack. So this is one of the things I got for them. Nimby loves it. This is one of the things I got for them. This is actually made for ferrets. They can actually go in here. I don't think he's figured that out yet though. I got this giraffe blanket. I got this blanket. There's other stuff too. Oh, I got this. This is all considered from Leanne. Even though I picked it. And that plushie, the pancake plushie. I got that too. Yes, so Nimby will be alone for now. Thursday is Flapjack's appointment at noon. So once he's hopefully cleared, he can come in here. And I'm gonna monitor them first. Nimby's grown really big. So he is like 1 pound, six and a half ounces now. He's really big. And I think Flapjack is like just about a pound. So they used to be closer in size, but Nimby just is like a bull. Won't stop growing. And he's so active. So we'll see if he's too rough with Flapjack. Flapjack's kind of a whiner. You guys will see. He's like, you like touch him and he's like, he just starts crying. So we'll see how it goes. They might need to have some like supervised visits first until we can like train Nimby how to be polite. He definitely has the single child syndrome going on. He will go and go and go and go and go. And then when he gets tired, wherever he decides to sleep, which hopefully will be here, but he fights it. He'll try to keep his head up until he does that thing where his head just collapses. You just tooted. I think you need to go potty. Yeah, Flapjack definitely needs a little, like, toughening up. He's kind of a little, like, little tiny baby. Slow down. Nope. Do you know where we're gonna potty? Flapjack is 5.5 weeks. Nimbus is 6.5 weeks. Yeah, Nimbus isn't going anywhere. Shelby can, or, not Shelby. Lizzie can come here. If you gotta go potty, you can take a play break. It's gonna be here. Well, that makes a different sound. Hi, Burley. Nope, no stripes. Just pure gray and white.
There was a little, at the vet's office, there was a, apparently in the back, a pool going, over whether Nimbus was named for a cloud or for Harry Potter. And, the vet was like, well, he's wrapped in a cloud blanket, so I think it's a cloud. And I guess, you know, other people were saying, no, it's gonna be Harry Potter. So he was very pleased that he was correct. No, I would rely on the adapter to retest him. They might be adopted together. They might not. It really depends. Nimby is growing really quickly, so he might very well be ready for adoption well before Flapjack is. And, you know, if they're not bonded, there's no reason to adopt them together, so. We'll see how it goes. I wanted Nimby to have someone that he. So solo kittens, see, he is very bitey with me. And it's really at this age where they learn not to be bitey because they're playing with their siblings and their siblings would be squealing at them and saying that's too hard and that's too rough. And that's where they learn not to be bitey cats. So yes, I could spend a lot of time squealing at him and hissing and pretending I'm a kitten, which I do. But it's definitely more effective if he has a kitten that's actually helping him learn that. So that was our. That was my main objective with getting him a buddy. So he doesn't turn into a little terror kitten. I need you to be nice and cuddle. Right? No terror kittens. Also, you keep tooting. I know you have to poop.